Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of a faulty knock sensor. A knock sensor on an engine is responsible for detecting any potential engine knock, also known as pre-ignition or detonation, and relaying that information back to the ECU or the engine control unit. The ECU then uses that data to properly adjust ignition timing and other vital engine parameters. Now, not all cars and engines are equipped with a knock sensor. However, they're very common in the modern era, especially the 2000s and up. They're very common since knock sensors can help an engine improve fuel economy and performance, and the way in which knock sensors help achieve that end goal of better performance and fuel economy is by allowing the engine to safely run more advanced ignition timing and essentially get a more complete and energetic burn of the air-fuel mixture. The reason for that is if engines without knock sensors were allowed to run more aggressively and run more ignition advance, then they would run into occasional engine knocks, detonations, which would ultimately reduce the lifespan and reliability of the engine. However, with these knock sensors in place, the ECU is able to very quickly determine if any knock events are occurring and then properly adjust the ignition timing and any other parameters as necessary to get the engine back to a point where it's achieving maximum performance without pushing the edge too far and running into severe and consistent engine knock. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common signs and symptoms of a faulty knock sensor. Number one on the list, we have the check engine light. This is the most basic and one of the most common symptoms associated with a bad knock sensor. When you get the check engine light, the reason for that is the knock sensor is a sensor that is sending signals back to the ECU. If the ECU notices there's something wrong with the signal, either it's not being received or the numbers are way off and something the ECU knows wouldn't be within normal operating range for the knock sensor, that will quickly trigger a check engine light and a stored fault code from the ECU. And the most common fault codes associated with problems with the knock sensor are anything between P0324 all the way up to P0334. So if you notice a check engine light and are getting any one of those fault codes, then that likely points you in the direction and helps pinpoint the issue as being with the knock sensor on the engine. Moving on to symptom number two of a faulty knock sensor, we have poor performance. So again, these knock sensors help the engine achieve maximum performance and efficiency by essentially optimizing the burn and being able to run as much ignition advance as possible. If the knock sensor is faulty, the ECU will typically go into a quote unquote safe mode and essentially limit ignition timing as well as adjust other parameters to keep the engine safe and healthy. And the reason for that is if the engine doesn't know whether it may be knocking or not, again, if you have a faulty sensor and it's not sending the right signal or no signal at all, the engine control unit has no idea whether there is any actual knock present in the engine. And so it's going to try to protect the engine by pulling out ignition timing and again, adjusting any other engine parameters as necessary. So ultimately when that happens, that's going to lead to worse performance and fuel economy, which leads me into symptom number three, and that is poor fuel economy. Again, this ties in very much like with the performance aspect and poor performance is when the engine essentially goes into a safety or kind of protection mode and it starts pulling out that ignition timing, you're going to get a less efficient burn of the air fuel mixture, which not only reduces power and performance, but will also result in worse fuel economy. Now, this symptom can often be hard to detect unless you're really paying very close attention to fuel economy. You might not notice because oftentimes it's not going to be a drastic difference. It's not going to be 15 miles per gallon instead of 22 miles per gallon. It might just be a small drop, maybe 1 or 2 miles per gallon. So this symptom can be hard to notice. But again, if you get it alongside poor performance, as well as a check engine light and any fault codes that are indicating an issue with the knock sensor, then poor fuel economy can simply be further confirmation that you do indeed have an issue with the knock sensor on your engine. Moving on to symptom number four, we have actual engine knock itself. Now, when you do have a faulty knock sensor, it's not very common for the engine to actually be knocking. Again, usually the ECU will try to protect the engine. However, if you're hearing or experiencing experiencing actual engine knock, it could potentially be a sign that there is simply an issue with the knock sensor. Or on the other hand, which would be more common if you're actually experiencing engine knock, there could be another problem that is severe enough to the point that the knock sensors and ECU cannot control the engine knock. And usually this would be some sort of fault code like a super knock, which would indicate exactly that the engine is picking up or detecting engine knock, but it can't seem to fix the problem or adjust parameters to reduce or get rid of that engine knock. So a lot of the times, again, if you're actually experiencing this, it could be indicative of a different problem that's causing the engine knock and not just the sensor. However, it is possible that a faulty knock sensor, depending on each vehicle and engine in question, and depending on how the ECU responds to a bad knock sensor, it very well could cause the engine to actually knock, which can be a very severe and costly issue, as consistent and repeated engine knocks do put a lot of additional stress on the engine. So if that's allowed to occur for a long period, you could run into engine failure or other very costly issues with the engine. So just something to be on the lookout for if you do have actual engine knock. It is a severe problem and something that you should limit driving the vehicle and get it diagnosed and repaired as soon as possible. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description for more. Thanks, everyone.